Timelapse, watercolor painting, distortion, sympathy.
At the point where I'm at right now, it's just the basic squares in the center, and there's some lines coming out that are kind of inspired by the blowing of a liquid watercolor puddle, and they kind of create these little veiny-looking, sort of drippy-looking kind of things that go out in tendrils, almost. And then I use those to create like a liquid flow around the image to create something that moves, you can follow it with your eye abstractly from one point to another. Now, it doesn't necessarily connect, but that's what I explore in my images as I'm painting. It's just exploring the relationships of negative space and composition, and that's a lot of where the forms in my art comes from, is just putting down shapes, finding out where they stack in the z-axis, in the order, the visual order of the image, from top to bottom, deep into the image, not like left and right, up and down. And then using their light and dark aspects to create edges, create detail, create texture, create the flow of the picture. There's like three main zones of detail in here. You kind of see them right away. It's the circles. It's the circles with the yellow boxes and the dark brown back set. And there's like a pink that's underneath even that. And, you know, that's where your eye gets sucked in. And it's part of like a wobbly triangulation theorem that I've constructed, where there's, your eye has to have three things to look at originally in the image to really kind of dig in. But once you have got those, you pick your favorite one, you go to the next, and you go to the next, and then it just spirals from that point. But you can't have a spiral with just a line, you need a triangle. But it's wobbly because there's no science behind this. It's just, I made this shit up. So, in terms of the color of this painting, I started off with yellow and went with orange and green, and then I kind of did this thing where I added some red and maroons and browns, kind of faded, pale versions of those. And later on, in the end of the image, I kind of turned it more into super saturated, bright versions. There's a lot of really bright yellow, really bright orange. These watercolors I use, Dr. P.H. Martin's concentrated, the radiant concentrated colors, and they're liquid, so you squirt them out of a little vial into like a dish. I have this egg crate looking thing that I paint out of, and it's, so what you get is super vibrant. Like the yellow is so bright, my eyes would be vibrating when I was looking at it, because it's, you know, under real bright lights when I'm painting. And then you start with white, and then you do the yellow on the white to go from the lightest colors to the darkest. What ends up happening is it creates a visual kind of a little bit of a zigzaggy, you know, when you look at like real sharp stripes and your eyes go, ah, oh my God, ah, my eyes. And like, but then you look away like a cloud and it's nice. Don't worry about it. But that's the kind of thing. So you can't quite get that in the digital version of the picture. You can't quite see. Yeah, you know. I mean, take what you want from it. You might see something in the painting, and you go like, whoa, I see like a, that thing. That's really kind of the fun part about looking at abstract art, is making something personal out of it. Thanks for watching. Go check out the links in the info, or go check out my website, jeffjag.com. Thanks.